Zoology webinar session. See, we started learning about human reproductive system, where a journey to mother's womb to the planet Earth, isn't it? Now, last session we have dealt with female reproductive system. Now today we will be learning about or knowing about more about the male reproductive system, especially the structure and the functioning. Now, today we have with us our presenter S. Satish Garu, PGT Zoology from Asibabad district. And he has masters of many in his kitty. He has mastered zoology, psychology, as well as in education. He has a vast experience of 24 years and he has worked as principal for various junior as well as degree colleges, as well as model schools too. Now, here in this chapter, just don't blindly watch the record. You have to take the pen, you have to note down all the terminologies and also the little bit functioning, so that whenever you revisit this channel again, it becomes easy, children. Okay? Okay. I welcome S. Satish Garu. Sir, good morning, sir.
Good morning, ma'am. Good morning, students. Good morning, students. Very good morning, ma'am. I welcome you all for the today's webinar session. And I would like to express my profuse thanks to Srimati Vijayalakshmi Garu as our coordinator and Srimati Shailaja Ma'am Garu, the webinar team head. Now, I would like to explain the reproductive system in the human male of chapter 50 of second year. Children, today's topic is male reproductive system. Today's topic is human male reproductive system. After completing the session, students, you may learn and able to identify the male reproductive system and differentiate it with female reproductive system. As you know, the female reproductive system in the earlier class, as Prashanthi Madam explained you. Today, I would like to explain in detail the human male reproductive system. And you can also differentiate with the female reproductive system and capable of drawing the label diagram of male reproductive system. That's why you need a paper and pen, children. Take your book and draw the diagram as early as possible. Actually, among the key points we discuss one by one, children. First is testis. Testis is otherwise called as testicles, the primary male sex organs. The key terms involved in our chapter is testis, scrotum, inguinal canal, gubernaculum, leading cells, epididymis, vas deferens, penis, seminal vesicles, prostate gland, bulbourethral glands, or Cowper gland. Children, we should discuss in detail one by one. Before going to discuss about these, we have to know the definition of reproduction. What is meant by reproduction? Reproduction is the biological process by which the new individual organisms or offsprings are produced from their parents. Next, reproduction. Types of reproduction is two types, asexual and sexual. The reproduction involves in the following steps. Gametogenesis, insemination, implantation, gestation, and parturition. These are the five steps involved in reproduction. Whereas gametogenesis is nothing but formation of gametes. Students, what is meant by gamete and what are the male gametes and female gametes? Actually, male gametes are sperm cells whereas female gametes are ova. Very good. Insemination, this is seen in only human male. Insemination is nothing but transfer sperms or gametes into the human female. Next, implantation. Implantation, it is seen in human female system, reproductive system. Thereby, the zygote is attached to the uterine wall. After fertilization occurs, as you are aware about it, the embryo is attached to the uterine wall. That is called implantation. Next, gestation. Gestation is nothing but embryonic development, the complete development of the embryo from its conception to its delivery. The last step involved in reproduction is parturition. Parturition is nothing but delivery of the baby from mother's womb. And this is a complete picture of reproduction that is involved in both human male and female. But I emphasize, children, today about the reproduction in human male system. As the reproduction is asexual and sexual, we have to know what is meant by asexual reproduction. Asexual reproduction, it involves in a single parent and no gamete formation takes place. What is meant by sexual reproduction? When two parents are involved and gamete formation takes place, it is called sexual reproduction. In sexual reproduction, two parents are involved. Whereas in asexual reproduction, only single parent is involved. The sexual reproduction starts 10 to 11 years of age in girls, whereas 12 to 13 years in boys when they attain puberty. Children, what is the purpose of reproduction? As the reproduction is the biological process, metabolic activity, what is the purpose of its, we have to know today. Continuation of species is the answer. We have to continue generation after generation. That is nothing but the continuation of species. A reproduction in human beings. Actually, as the human being, we have to know what is meant by reproduction and how it is going on in the male. Human beings attain sexual maturity, which is called puberty. When human being attains puberty, automatically the reproductive organisms are developed. That is 10 to 11 years in girls and 12 to 13 years at age in the boys. And children, you know that your age is teenage. This ends around the age of 18th year in girls and 19th year in boys. This phase is also called teenage, and they are called teens. In the teenage, puberty is developed. Human reproduction is the production of young ones by organism. Humans are sexually reproducing and viviparous. Children, you think you know about oviparous. The reptiles and apes may lay eggs. Laying eggs are called oviparous, whereas the human being, the children is born from the mother's womb is called viviparous. That's why human being is a viviparous one. Viviparous. Next, human reproduction consisting of male reproductive system and female reproductive system. The classification of important organs. Primary sex organs and secondary sex organs are there. What are the primary sex organs in male children? Right. Yes. Testis is the primary sex organ. And ovaries. Ovaries are the primary sex organs in human female. Secondary sex organs are accessory organs that are present in both male and female. It will be discussed later on. Now, in the male reproductive system, there are two types of organs are there. Some are located externally, some are located internal. The external genital organs, reproduction mainly depends upon the genitalia, which are present in both male and female. The external genitalia are penis and scrotum. Internal genital organs, testis, epididymis, vas deferens, and accessory glands. Accessory glands are seminal vesicles, prostate glands and bulbourethral glands. Children, you have to understand this after explaining with this diagram. This diagram indicates that this diagram is already, that is there in our textbook. Here, the testis is there here, scrotum is there. Testis, scrotum, epididymis is there, vas deferens, and the corpus gland, prostate gland, ejaculatory duct, seminal vesicle. And these are the parts that are in the, that are belongs to the human male reproductive system. And we can discuss in detail. This is the diagrammatic explanation of human male reproductive system. It is very much important, children. You have to make it practice, and it will be asked in annual examinations under 8 marks question. This is male reproductive system diagram. The green part, this is nothing but this is a penis part. The opening of penis is called a glans penis, and in the middle of this, urethra is present. Urethra is useful for ejaculation, excretion of urine from this passage, as well as ejaculation of sperm cells. This passage through urethral opening or the opening through the glans penis to the female reproductive parts. There are testes are located. The testes, primary male sex organs located in the scrotal sac, a pouch of skin located outside the abdominal cavity. Then this diagram is there. With this, we can understand that this is the testis. This testis is the sperm producing organ that produces the sperm cells, and which are going through this vas deferens, and thereby it mixes with the semen. And prostate is also secreting the some prostate gland secretions, and it will be ejaculated up whenever they require. Next, testes or testicles. It includes male primary sex organs, a pair of testicles, a pair of testicles either side of the scrotal sac. These are embedded. This testis is oval in shape. This is ovoid in shape, and this is located. These are light are located in the scrotal sac. Testis is otherwise called as testicle. Single testis and plural are testicles or testes. The length of the testis is 4 to 5 centimeter. They are present outside the abdominal cavity. That abdominal cavity is called scrotum. Scrotum is the pouch of skin formed from the lower part of the abdominal wall. And the scrotum keeps the testis at temperature slightly cooler than the body temperature. Children, what is our body temperature? Actually, 37 degrees to 38 degrees centigrade, our body temperature is there. But in scrotum, only 35 degrees centigrade, to it maintains some low temperature due to the protection of the sperm cells. That's why due to maintain the sperm cells in a better manner, it is located outside of the abdominal cavity. Next, inguinal canal. It is the cavity of the scrotal sac connected to the abdominal cavity. This is inguinal canal. Next, all the testes are present in not only the mammals, or that is, those are also present in reptiles and monotreme mammals, and some scrotal mammals are there. The testes are located like this. Next, we have to go through a glance about the diagrams of human male reproductive system. Here, prostate gland is there. Prostate is a gland which secretes the prostate juice. Urethra is there. Urinary bladder. Urinary bladder is nothing but this belongs to the excretory system. Excretory system and reproductive system, those are collectively working in a single system. That's why this may be also called as urinogenital system. Urinogenital system is a kind, is nothing but it is the both reproductive and excretory system. The vas deferens is there, vas deferens. This is the vas deferens. Vas deferens. This is a pink line. This is starting from the epididymis part and closing with here at seminal vesicles and prostate gland. Yellow color part is there. The vas deferens is there. Prostate glands are there and epididymis is there. Testicles and penis is there. The penis is the intromittent organ that can ejaculate these sperms whenever they participate in copulation. The scrotal sacs are separated by a thin membranous fold called scrotal septum. Two scrotal sacs separated by a thin membranous fold called scrotal septum. That means it is divided, children. The testicles are formed in the embryonic stage. They descend later on. After the gestation period is completed, before the parturition or delivery, they can descend later on. If they weren't able to descend into the scrotal sac, some kind of a phenomenon is seen here that is called cryptorchidism. In the cryptorchids, the testis does not locate in scrotal sacs. That is called a cryptorchidism. Two scrotal sac. Next, when the male fetus is developing, testis are developed in the abdominal cavity. Scrotal sac is empty at that time. But during the embryonic development, During the embryonic development, they descend into the scrotal sac. Like after the descent, each testis is held in a position in each scrotum by a fibrous cord. Fibrous tissue or fibrous cord, that fibrous cord is called as gubernaculum. Here, the diagrammatic representation is there. Here, testis are there. Testis are embedded or located in the scrotal sac by a fibrous cord called gubernaculum. Each testis is covered by fibrous envelope that is called tunica albuginea. Tunica albuginea, this envelope, this is the tunica albuginea. This is testis, total testis is covered with this. And tunica albuginea forms internal septa due to the foldings on the inner side called a testicular septum. Testicular septa are there in this testicular septum. Tunica albuginea forms internal septa. That means foldings. These foldings are called internal septa. The foldings are testicular septum. Due to the testicular septum, the testis is nearly 250 testicular lobules or compartments are formed in each testis. That means each testis having approximately about 250 testicular lobules in which the sperm cells are producing. Where the sperm cells are produced? In the testis, in the lobules of the testis only. Children, now tunica vaginalis. While looking at the word tunica vaginalis, vagina is the external internal part of the female reproductive system, but the word tunica vaginalis refers to the male reproductive system. In many of the entrance examinations or competitive examination, the tunica vaginalis is asked, so you have to concentrate it. The outer side of the tunica albuginea, tunica vaginalis, here tunica vaginalis is there, the outer side, the outermost part, tunica vaginalis, which protects another layer. That means tunica vaginalis is the outermost layer of the testis, which protects called as tunica vaginalis. Tunica vaginalis is specially present in the testis, not in the vagina. Once again, you have to remember, children, tunica vaginalis is the outermost layer around the tunica albuginea present in human testis only. Next, in the each lobule, there are seminiferous tubules are there. Seminiferous tubules. Sperms are formed by spermatogonial mother cells in seminiferous tubules. Seminiferous tubules, next. This is the testis, children. The seminiferous tubules are these. These are all the lobules. In each lobule, the seminiferous tubules are producing the sperm cells. That means manufacturing or production of sperms are, these are the manufacturing units, I think. The sperm cells are produced in the seminiferous tubules, which enters into the reticular network. This reticular network is called retitestis. Retitestis, from which they can move forward through the vasa efferentia. The small tubules called collecting ducts called vasa efferentia. The vasa collect the sperm cells, which are carrying to the folded ring, folded structure. This folded structure is nothing but, children, epididymis. Epididymis plays a vital role in maintaining with this system. Epididymis is nothing but, it is a coiled or folded structure in which temporarily the sperm cells are stored, and it will be sent from this duct to the urethral passage or ejaculatory duct. Next, children, if we want to take this only mature sperm cell, we have to take the lobe, single lobe, in which mature sperm cells are there. Here, these sperm cells having tail and head position, in which some sort of nourishing cells are there. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. These cells are supporting cells to this epithelial cells. These cells, each and every cell is developing as a sperm cell, for which the supporting cells are useful for nourishment of the sperm cells. And we have to know clearly about these cells in detail. Seminiferous tubules are lined by two types of cells, male germ cells or spermatogonic cells. These may undergo meiotic divisions. And the supporting cells are there, as I told, these Sertoli cells. They provide nutrition to the germ cells. Sertoli cells are nothing but supporting cells. They will give nutrition to the germ cell, children. These are the Sertoli cells. These are the leading cells. Leading cells are interstitial cells. They can produce the hormone called testosterone. Whereas the Sertoli cells, these are the nourishment cells. These are the supportive cells that give nutrition to these sperm cells. Leading cells and Sertoli cells. Sertoli cells. The leading cells are interstitial cells. They produce androgens, in which testosterone is most important. Testosterone. Children, what is meant by testosterone? Testosterone is a hormone secreted by the testis of the leading cells. Leading is nothing but, it is identified by a scientist called Leading in 1850s, that after his name, the leading cells were coined. The testosterone is a hormone. That means we consider this testis as an endocrine gland also. Do you know, children, what are the endocrine glands? Yes, pituitary gland, adrenal gland, like that. Yes, thyroid gland also. This is also a gland. That also, the glands that are secreting hormones are called endocrine glands. Like that, the testosterone hormone is secreted by the testis. That's why the testis is also calling as endocrine gland. Testosterone is a hormone which controls the secondary sexual characters or spermatogenesis. You know the secondary sexual characters, as you have learned at 10th class. The secondary sexual characters, whenever the individual attain the age of puberty, the secondary sexual characters may be developed in the individuals. You see the seminiferous tubule here, testis here, epididymis, and vas deferens. Here, every seminiferous tubule consisting of these sperm cells, germinal cells, and Sertoli cells are there here. These are the Sertoli cells. These are the spermatogonial mother cells of type 2 and type A2, type A1. Spermatogonial mother cells, they develop in this seminiferous tubule. and they forms a sperm cell. Millions of sperm cells are produced from each lobule, and millions of sperm cells are ejaculated when it is participating in the copulation. Next, children. Each lobule has 1 to 3 high coiled seminiferous tubules. Each seminiferous tubule is lined with germinal epithelium. This is called germinal epithelium, as the ovaries also. Spermatogonial mother cells and nourishing cells are called Sertoli cells, as we were discussed. Here, this diagram indicates that it is performing meiosis. Here mitosis is there, here meiosis 2 is there, meiosis 1 is there. These two cell divisions, especially in these, mitosis is nothing but it is the cell is dividing to two. One cell is dividing to two cells is called mitosis. But meiosis is a reduction division, thereby the chromosomal number is decreased. The primary spermatocyte in 2 and diploid condition may be reduced, and it is deducted into 1N condition or haploid condition. The diploid one is again formed a single haploid cell, secondary spermatocyte. Primary spermatocyte undergoes meiosis 1, and 2 haploid secondary spermatocytes are formed. Next, into the meiosis 2, all the 4 spermatids are formed. This from secondary spermatocyte, the spermatozoa or the sperm cells are originating. This process is called spermiogenesis. From the spermatogonium to spermiogenesis or spermatozoa formation, this entire process is called spermatogenesis. Spermatogenesis is nothing but the complete process of formation of sperm cells. This is the seminiferous tubule in which the cross-section of seminiferous tubule indicates the lumen in which a small cavity is present. Here, Sertoli cells are there here, spermatogonia are there, interstitial cells are the leading cells are there. They are helpful for the secretion of testosterone. Interstitial tissue is there, lymphatic capillaries are there, some Sertoli cells are there, early spermatids are there. The early spermatids develop into the complete spermatozoa, for which arteriole is there, the arteriole which connects the blood through the artery to the blood is supplying. Next, cryptorchidism. Scrotum, we were discussed about the scrotum. Scrotal sac is the pouch of skin located outside the abdominal sac. But cryptorchidism is a condition when man testes do not descend into the scrotum, or there are 2 testes in each scrotum. Exactly, so 2 testes are there, but testes enlarge in the scrotum, that is not. Testes degenerate in the scrotum, that is not. Testes do not descend into the scrotum is a condition that is called cryptorchidism. This cryptorchidism, actually testes may descend after the gestation period is completed. Before the delivery, 2 to 3 weeks, they may descend into the scrotal sac. If that is not happened, automatically there may be a problem arises in the individual, that those who are without having the testes outside the abdominal cavity, those are called cryptorchids. This phenomenon is called cryptorchidism, without scrotal sacs. In most of the mammals, testes are located in scrotal sac. In most of the mammals, testes are located in scrotal sac. Here, answer is spermatogenesis. Testes are located in the scrotal sac for spermatogenesis. Not sex differentiation, not for more space to visceral organ, not for independent function of kidney. Testes is different, children. Kidneys are different. The testes is oval shaped or big. Look, don't misconcept here. Testes are different, then the kidneys are different. Kidneys are located in the back side of our body. Testes are located in the ventral side in the lower abdomen. Which of the following is the endocrine tissue of the testes? Endocrine part means what, children? endocrine is nothing but it is secreting hormone. The testosterone is hormone is secreting by testis. From which cells? Sertoli cells? No. Leading cells. Very good. Leading cells is the right answer for this question. Epidermis, inguinal canal, leading cells and spermatic cord. Leading cells is the right answer for this question. Which cells in the testis secrete testosterone? Just now we were discussed. Here, interstitial cells is another name as given, or cells of leading is also given in twisting this question. Interstitial cells are leading cells, one and the same children. So you have to write down A as its answer. Testis secrete testosterone by interstitial cells are cells of leading or leading cells. The elastic cells, the elastic tissue which connects the cauda epididymis to the scrotal sac. Actually, children, we can know the answer about the this in clear after explaining the epididymis. Epididymis is having carpate epididymis, cauda epididymis, and caput epididymis, in which the elastic tissue connects the cauda epididymis to the scrotal sac is gubernaculum. This is another word, gubernaculum. It is a connective tissue. The accessory ducts that are in the male reproductive system are epididymis, vasa differentia, and urethra. Epididymis. Vasa tightly called epididymis. Here I explain here now. These are the folding. These connecting tubules are vasa efferentia. These are the small tubules, vasa efferentia, but this large tubule is called vas deferens. Vas deferens is the large tubule which starts from the epididymis. Vasa efferentia are the collecting tubules which are starting from the retitestis. Retitestis is the reticular network which is present in the testis. Epididymis are tightly coiled tubes located against the testis. Tightly coiled, like this foldings. Epididymis acts as a maturation and storage for sperm cells. It acts as maturation of the sperm cell as well as storage space for sperm cells. Now we have to emphasize on the epididymis. Epididymis consisting caput epididymis, corpus epididymis, and cauda epididymis. Corpus, cauda. What children? Caput epididymis, corpus epididymis, and cauda epididymis. Three parts of epididymis. Here we can see the epididymis here. This is the folded structure is the epididymis. This is the three-dimensional diagram. This total is a testis. Next, tail is called cauda epididymis. Head is called corpus epididymis, middle part is. As we discussed, middle part is called corpus epididymis here, children. Next, vasa differentia. Vas deferens or vasa differentia are plural. Vas deferens means only single tube from each testis. Vasa differentia is a long, thin muscular tube that starts from the tail of the epididymis to the urethra in the penis. Okay, urethra is useful for both urine and as well as the semen, which is ejaculated out at the time of copulation with the female. This is lined with the pseudo-stratified epithelium. Vas differentia is lined with the pseudo-stratified epithelial tissue. And vas deferens and the duct of the seminal vesicle unite to form a short ejaculatory duct. From the seminal vesicles, the vas deferens unite to form ejaculatory duct. They transport sperm from the epididymis in anticipation of ejaculation, sending out. Actually, this clear diagram shows that these are the seminal vesicles. Here, the vas ejaculatory ducts are there. Ejaculatory duct which is opens into this urethra. Urethra is this. Whenever the excretory system works, automatically the reproductive system stops. If it is in function, reproductive system in function, automatically excretory system stops. It is a combined collective urinogenital system performing with a single organ through urethra. That's why this urinogenital system is, this is otherwise called as urinogenital system also. This is a prostate gland. This is the bulbourethral gland or Cowper gland. This secretes its juice, which is in acidic condition. Here we have to see one more surgical procedure here. These are the two testes are located in the scrotal sac. Two testes. These are the foldings of the, what are these folding, coil folding children? These coil foldings are epididymis. The epididymis from which the vas deferens, from here one, this one and this one are the vas deferentia or vas deferentia. Vas deferens in singular, vasa deferentia in plural. Vasa deferentia means these may be, this is a surgical procedure here, cut. It has to be cut open, and vasectomy, a family planning operation done to the male is called vasectomy. Children, do you know what is the family planning operation done to the human female? Okay, it is tubectomy. Here, vasectomy is a surgical procedure that may be made to the male only, with which the sperms does not enter into this seminal vesicles or through urethra, it can't be passed out. That's why the family birth control method is used, vasectomy surgical procedure in male. Here, urethra. This is located here. Urethra is the common passage for ejaculating sperm cells and sending out the urine from the urinary bladder. These are the kidneys, children. Here are the testes. This is the urinary bladder. Whatever the kidneys secret the urine must be stored in the urinary bladder, but this can be ejaculated, this can be pulled out by the process of excretion. That is called micturition. Micturition is nothing but the sending out the stored urine from the urinary bladder, from the urethra to the outside is called micturition. Two ejaculatory ducts join at the center of the prostate and opens into the urethra. It is a common duct, reproductive and urinary systems. 20 cm in males, 4 cm in females. In females, urethra is very small. Originate from the neck of the urinary bladder and extends through the penis to its outer opening called urinary meatus. The outer opening of the penis is called urinary meatus. Next. This is also a diagram, 3D diagram here, children. This is the urethral opening, urethra common passage from which the Cowper gland or bulbourethral gland, this is opening to the urethra. This one is the ejaculatory duct here. This is seminal vesicles. From semen, the semen or sperm, semen, whatever the sperm cells sent to the seminal vesicles are stored here, and this is entering to the ejaculatory duct to the urethra, and urethra, through this urethral passage, the sperm cells are ejaculated out during copulation. Accessory glands are there here, seminal vesicles, prostate glands and Cowper glands. Seminal vesicles, they can store the semen here. Sperm, the prostate glands also, accessory glands here, they can produce its juice. Cowper's glands are bulbourethral glands. These also play a vital role in male reproductive system. This is also a diagrammatic representation as in your textbook, it is there. Next, this is also the diagram. Next, seminal vesicles. If you want to know about a few points about this seminal vesicles, these seminal vesicles are pale structures here, attached to the vas deferens at one side of the bladder. This is the urinary bladder. Two pairs of seminal vesicles are located here. About 60% of seminal fluid, 60% of seminal fluid is produced from this. They produce a sticky yellowish alkaline fluid that contains, the semen contains of fructose, proteins, citric acid, potassium and prostaglandins. Prostaglandins aid in fertilization by making cervix receptive to sperms. The sperm is attached to the ovum. The fertilization takes place in the fallopian tube, where the prostaglandins play a vital role the acrosome of the sperm cell, it can attach to the ovary there, in which the prostaglandins make a vital role. And this is the diagrammatic representation. As in your textbook, you have to practice it, children. The labeling and everything you have to do neatly. The diagram contains 4 marks and the explanation contains 4 marks. It may be an 8 marks question in IP. Prostaglandins is specially present. It surrounds the ejaculatory duct at the base of the urethra below the urinary bladder, which also secretes 15% to 30% of semen. This is slightly acidic in condition. Okay, this is also producing semen. Seminal vesicles also producing semen. The semen and the sperm are different. Semen is the juice. Sperm cells are producing from the testis only. Here, the prostate is responsible for making reduction of semen, a liquid mixture of sperm cells and prostate fluid and seminal fluid. Seminal fluid, prostate fluid, and mixture of sperm cells. It provides nutrition and activates the sperms. Prostate juice provides nutrition, like Sertoli cells provide nutrition to the sperm cells. This is an additional accessory gland that also provides nutrition to the sperm cells. Most type of cancer in males is a prostate cancer. As the cervical cancer has appeared in human female reproductive system, here prostate cancer is seen in the human male reproductive system. Next, children, which of these is an accessory reproductive gland in males? Is it inguinal canal or prostate gland or mushroom shaped gland or gastric gland? Okay, prostate gland. Very good, children. Next, this diagram, especially this diagram is looking like a male reproductive system, but penis bone is not having in human male children. An organ does not having bone in human being, but the penis bone is a separate structure that is present in other mammals like chimpanzee and gorilla. Penis bone is especially present here. This is the boneless structure which is present in human male. But this is asked in the entrance examination, where the penis bone is present in which mammal. Gorilla and chimpanzee are the very good examples for it. But human male does not having penis. But as myself is explaining today, means this zoologist is explained here, but penis bone is there in the human male reproductive system is a misconcept here. As I am explaining, penis bone is present in gorilla and chimpanzee, not in human male reproductive system. Also called as barbourethral gland. There are two small glands located on the sides of the urethra just below the prostate gland. Cowper's glands, these are the Cowper's small glands are there. These are also called bulbourethral glands. Secretion of these glands produce a clear slippery fluid that lubricates the urethra. They act as a flushing agent to wash out acidic urinary residues that may remain in the urethra. Okay, the Cowper glands are also called as bulbourethral glands. These are very much important. Bulbourethral glands are especially seen in human male reproductive system. These are otherwise called as Cowper glands. Another name for bulbourethral glands. Now only we are recapitulating it. Cowper's gland is the right answer. Perineal glands and prostate glands and meibomian glands are different. But the Cowper glands are another name for bulbourethral gland. The penis. Penis is nothing but it is an intromittent organ to transport both urinary sperms. It is an intromittent organ that transfers the sperms into the vagina. It contains spongy tissue that becomes turgid erect when filled with blood. It facilitates insemination. Insemination is the process where the penis can conduct it. It is participating in the copulation. But it is having tissues, the two dorsal corpora cavernosa and one ventral corpus spongiosum tissues. Here, ventral corpus spongiosum tissue and dorsal corpora cavernosa. Corpora cavernosa is dorsal, CD. Corpora cavernosa in dorsal and CS in ventral. Corpus spongiosum, spongious structure. Just like elastic nature, it can folds automatically. When it receives It receives a desire from the opposite gender, automatically spongiosum expands. The cone-shaped tip of the penis is called glans penis. Glans penis is nothing but this tip of this end of this penis is called glans penis. It is covered by prepuce, the loose skin. Foreskin of this is called the skin, foreskin. Foreskin of the glans penis is called prepuce. This may be asked in 2 months question, children. What is meant by prepuce? Prepuce is this loose skin present nearby the glans penis region or anterior part of the penis region or head part of the penis region. This prepuce, it is covered. And this next. Actually, we have to recapitulate it once again about this. Seminiferous tubules opens into the ready testis, and those entering to the epidermis, those are also entering to the vasa deferens, and which is entering to the urethra, which is entering to the vagina of female when copulation is occurred. This is the flow chart. Actually, the flow chart, as per this flow chart, seminiferous tubules, they produce the sperm cells, and ready testis is a reticular network from which the vasa efferentia collecting. Thereby, in epididymis, those are stored in a parotid and enters into the vas deferentia. There the tubular structures are there, which the collective tubule urethra is there, from which the penic the urethra is present in the penis region, and it is ejaculated out to the vagina of the female when it is attaining the sexual reproduction. Let us recap what we have learned, children. Testis, epididymis, vas deferens, penis, accessory genital glands. These are all we were discussed now. Now, after having the session, you can also describe the microscopic structure of male reproductive system, draw a label diagram of the male reproductive system, describe the structure of seminiferous tubule, describe the male reproductive system, and draw a label diagram of it. This is the homework given to you, children. This may be concentrated under 4 marks and 8 marks questions in IPE. So you have to concentrate it. The attributes, I have collected the information through these attribute, children. Okay, with which I can conclude. And at last, I am very much thankful to this additional director, sir, Sri Satyanarayana Reddy sir garu, Raju sir, the joint director of our model schools, and the webinar team head, Shailja ma'am, and our course coordinator, Srimati Vijayalakshmi ma'am, and each and everyone, and Prashanti ma'am. I express my special thanks to Prashanti ma'am, as she expressed female reproductive system earlier than to me. Thank you, one and all. Thank you, ma'am. Thank you, children.
Yeah, thank you, sir. It was very good presentation and very informative session. Children, in this session, you have come across so many terminologies about male reproductive system, isn't it? So what you have to do? You have to write down each and every point. Okay. So especially, sir has covered IPE as well as NEET exams, few questions, isn't it? All those points also, whenever you are writing, you have to highlight those things. So again, if you don't understand the, like in the flow of this record, so what you have to do is you have to go on, revisit the channel. So that what happens, once you revisit the channel, what happens? You'll remember the things more clearly, and you can have a beautiful notes on this too. Okay. Have a great, children. Very thank you, sir.
Thank you, ma'am. Thank you.